You guys have any comments from yesterday? Anything you want to share with us? Did it all work out well? Anything we can change? No? Go ahead. All right. Well, then we start deeper.
Okay. Everyone is here, right? Okay. So we will start with Google Colab. Google Colab is, you can run Google Colab in your browsers, and you have to go to first this link, colab.research.google.com. And for starting this, you all need to have a Gmail account. Do you all have your Gmail accounts? Everyone? Okay.
Yeah, let's make sure everybody has gotten that to this page. And
yes.
Hey, Deepa.
Yeah.
They have Nexus restricting from entering Google Colab.
What is it?
Because these are people running laptops. They have certain limitations to certain sites. Yeah. They don't have access to Google Colab. They are not putting the complexity as well as
online laptop.
No, Colab is an official airline, right? No, that's the that's how it is.
Yeah, I can.
How many of you couldn't extend the Google Collaborator?
Can you try this website if you are?
You can use Kaggle to do that, right? To build it in the library.
Can you try this website?
Yeah, it lets them enter.
Yeah, okay.
Make it bigger.
So whoever was able to start the Google Colab, you need to start with a new notebook. Who all are working on Google Colabs? Two? Just two? Okay, three. Okay. Yeah, so you need to start with a new notebook in that. And you can rename that notebook to Python Hands-On Session.
Did you stop recording? How does
It doesn't give me record, but
Okay. So Python is a very popular programming language right now, and it will be very helpful for learning machine learning, artificial intelligence, web development, and many applications like generating APIs and using it for chatbots and other examples, which we have seen yesterday, like programming of robotics, planning, knowledge, understanding, and everything. And today in 2023, it's the topmost programming language is and used by like all of the famous programmers. So we will start learning it by doing some basic hands-on session. And I planned this session according to notebooks, but now notebooks are not working. But we will start with calculating the seconds in a day. So you can try this thing in your Python.
Much larger, much larger.
And you have to just hit run after doing that.
Just so you know, that's a variable. So you can put anything. It doesn't have to be seconds in a day.
Yeah, maybe I can start here. So there, that was the screen which was running here. Then it will just print hello world, because we have put the hello world in that. And now we can do seconds. Yeah. So you have to write this thing in your compiler.
So she was showing it in notebook, you'll need to change it a little bit to run it here.
So if you run it, the output will be like this, because we have a hello world print before that. So here, print is a function that will take the argument in it, like in the parentheses, everything you write into the column, like the double quotes, it will print everything. That was a string, it needed the double quote. But if it's a variable, like we are assigning value to a variable, then you don't need to put it into the double quotes. Otherwise, it will just print like this. If you put seconds in a day into the print function, it will put print seconds in a day, because it will treat that variable as a string. So you need to be careful that you should mention only this thing and then run it, then it will show the output of that variable. Let's do this thing. Print and then take I will show you the example what you have to do. Okay, so we will start with some basic operations and the basic basic terminologies in the Python. So first of all, we will start with list. So list in a Python can be a collection of elements that can be multiple values like this. 1, 2, 3, or you can put lists like in the square brackets, you can put strings like names, and then you can put any values that you want to store in that list. Let's say list of 1 to 10. So that will have integers from 1 to 10. And if you want to list like all of the students here, name with name of all the students in that list, that will be stored in the my list. So let's do this experiment, and then I will give you a little bit exercise about this. And we have this list, and in my list, we are storing integers separated by comma. And then printing my list. So it will print like this. Are you able to see it?
What you have done initially is you have created an empty list and then you populated with the values.
Is everyone able to do it? So all of you who have already done it, you can go to this website. I am pasting this link, and I have a little bit exercise of you for there. Are they able to go in GitHub? GitHub?
Yes, ma'am. Can they access that doc?
Yeah, they can.
But even if they access it, they won't be able to put it on.
But they can use in the compiler, list and all, right? No, but I can send this to their teacher.
Yeah.
So ask her email ID, I can send it. You need to go to this website. There is a little bit exercise for you on the Google Colab. can send the whole repo here, right?
Link to the repo.
Main. That was correct, you know, right?
You can show them how to compute prime numbers from 1 to 100.
And you can do this exercise by creating a fruits variable name and then putting into the following order, and then you have to print the fruits. You just need to create a fruits variable and then just print it. So this will be a string list, that all are string, all these names are strings. So it will be a list of strings right now. Any name, anything which you want to print is a string in double quotes.
Anybody needs help, but just raise hand, okay? So you can start from the beginning if you need to.
You need to put a hard bracket here, that will then keep me gonna clear. Make more tools and release. Which is not a least right now. It would like a card record like your mileage. Now the number and put them to the
mileage.
But you can also like, you can obviously just say that fruits is for the mileage. Now, okay, so every one of these may have you are printing mileage, but mileage, can you see the difference in CV or the result? You have double quotes down. That way, excluding then read exactly what you look like, and
is everyone good? Printing the fruits names, I can show you here.
The speed is the
So you need to do like this. Is everyone able to do that? Okay, so now the next thing will be how to access this list. So if in lists or in Python generally, everything indexing starts with zero. So apple will be zero, banana will be one, orange will be two, and kiwi will be three. So if we want to print only just one, like one element at zero index, so what it will be? Yes. So we will print like this. And it will just print apple. So you knew, so the second in this was the accessing the elements, how you will access it. Now you can try the negative indexing, fruits and minus one, and see what's the output of this thing. What output did you get all? Did you understand anything? So it will start from the end of the list if you put the minus one in that. Yeah.
If you put minus two, you're going to see the
orange.
Second last.
Yeah. Now we will learn how to add elements to the existing list. So there is a list, my list. In that my list, we have 1, 2, 3. Now, if we want to add the element at the end of the list, we will do dot append. And then just print my list. So you have to do this dot append. Yes. Yes.
That's why I was really like, I was being happy to like send this over for like that. And you won't have to like think that you can do Google will have us very good.
Now we will try this thing because you all guys are in the online compiler. We will try to add another list into the fruits. So we have this fruits list still there. And in the fruits list, we will do like this. Let me do here. Just put a comma here and put another list inside it. Name me some fruits. What? Sorry? Tomatoes is not a fruit.
Yes, yes.
Any other fruit name? Hmm? Yeah. So if we print this thing now, yeah. So it will print a list inside of a list. If you put a list inside a list, it will print like this, that it's a list, but it is inside a list. And then you want to access the last element of the list, like minus one. It will just give you the last list. Because that is the whole one element. Then go like this. And then if you want to access inside that list, you need to again mention the indexing of that list. If you do like this, it will give tomatoes. And if you again do a minus one here, it will give you grapes. Is it visible?
By the way, when you have something within something, let's say for instance here list within another list, you the trunk is pointed as nested. So it's a nested list. And there can be nested other things. You will see in a while. You have loops,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So when Shiru talks about the loops, you can have loops within loops, and that would be nested loops. So this one is a nested list.
Here it is showing something wrong. D7 was available to the for that. If you bring my thing, we're going to see 1, 2, 3, then 4, 5, 6, 7, another list, and then 7. 7 does have another single list. Just bring my list above 11. So we are pretty much the last element is minus 7. So we were trying to access minus 7 and minus 1. Minus one is the last element of
That
okay, if I just find
Now we can access the, like, we can put from, if we want to print just one or two elements, we can put like 0 to 1, it will print just one element because it just have one element in it. But if we print like 0 to 2, it will print 2. And if we want to do like 2 to 4, it will print. So you need to separate it by a colon in between and then put the indexing of what all elements you want to print.
That is minus 2. Many of them are not able to even open the GitHub thing also. I don't know.
But we have put it here, right? All good? So the another way of concatenation of lists is you put a plus sign in between and then add two lists. So we have a list one in that we have 1, 2, and 3. In list two, we have 4, 5, 6. If we want to concatenate that, then we need to put a plus symbol between each of them and assign it to a new list. And then we will print it. So this will be the output of this. If you have list 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, and this will be the concatenation of that list. And you can try this.
This is why Python is like the best language to start with, just English, just add some more. Numbers.
Okay, now we will move to strings. So we have already seen some example of strings, but now we will see how to print exactly the number which we want to access. Like see, this is the text, some text in it, and you want to print the space between that or print E. So you have to put the exactly that number in it. So you all can try this one also, like to print a single element in a list, because this will give 0, 1, 2, 3. Then space is also counted. That is 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So you can print all of these by accessing the index number of that string.
In one dimension, and put the thing out on the way above and outside of the.
So you can try, if you have all tried this thing, like to print the print inside the string, like which element, then you can try this one, that string one plus double quotes, that will add a space to it, and then plus string two. It will work similar like list did, like it will concatenate the two strings into a single one. And you can assign it to a single variable then. Just put a print in front of it if you are doing it on the compiler. If you are doing it in Colab, that is fine.
Like that is writing and that's very fine and follow this. You can do just like 0, 1, 2, 3, this is 100 and follow this. Okay, you can do it or you can count hard even to the end.
Okay, so we will move to the next concept, that is conditions. So conditions in Python allow you to make decisions and execute like different blocks of decisions according to the, like if you have a condition that if it is raining or not. If it is raining, then you will take an umbrella outside. And if it is not raining, you will not take umbrella. Like that only, we have conditions. And we can put conditions in if, else if, and else loops. And we can also make a loop like if, and then directly else. So you can try this thing. Like it is a little bit of coding that you are assigning variables to, assigning a 5 to a my variable. And then you are checking that my variable is greater than 0 or less than 0 or equals to 0. So you can just try this one. If it will be less than 0, it will print negative. If it is greater than 0, it will print positive. So we don't put anything in the else condition. I have put a comment over here. This hash is a comment. Whenever you do anything in the Python, then you have to push, like you want to put your notes in front of it, then you put hash. That will be commented out. And in else condition, it will do everything else which is not being covered in these two conditions.
Yeah, ELF means else if, that is the short form in Python. Else if is in C++, that language is not done. You can also put else if something.
need a property. Then
So let's move to how to take an input from user and check if that variable is positive or negative. So we need to take input, like my variable, we put over there 5. Now we need to see that if a user put an input, and if we want to check that input, if it is negative or positive. So we will use this code only. And instead of doing this, we will do my variable and then what is it? Input doesn't work here on the compiler. This thing, int input.
Should work.
It's not working. It says not defined. Oh. Yeah. So, yeah. So if you do like this, like you have to assign a variable in an empty list, or you can directly just take a variable also. So it will ask you the number and you just put -7 in it, it will return negative. Now you can ask like how many times you will run it. It will ask you a number and it will ask user a number. And then it will return that user entered a positive or a negative number. Yeah.
No, they were not good for me, but if we can use the comp, I would. Isn't on the like on all the networking things, and it's still blocked it through my Google account. So they were, and even I went to my private Google, but because the whole, you know, it was, it was like, nice try. So they just don't block it for me, and I can get it so far maybe next year or whatever. If the vet tells me I need to work with.
Yeah, so
they exactly. I used it 2 years ago, so I was like, oh, it's fine. It's like, they caught up, okay.
For any of you, if you need
comments
on the labs at some point, or if you're doing research for that, you can get it unblocked, but it's going to take like a special one.
If you are good with that, we can move to the exercise we have for you here. So you have to create a grade calculator and write a program that takes a student score and put this all thing into if-else loop. Like you did to print a negative or positive number. Will you be able to do it right now? You have to create a grade calculator and provide a grade to the student. If a student is having 90 or above, you need to print A. If the score is between 80 to 89, you have to print B. If the score is between 7 to 79, you have to print C, and so on. So can you do that? And take an input from user and ask that enter your score. They're a little bit slow. Now you have to go around 10:45 for pick up sandwiches. We ordered Subway sandwiches.
Who is doing next?
I am.
Oh, you just want to take in the break, you want to go?
A and B. Like A and B both. Next is Vedant and then Kaushik. Hmm? Kaushik and Vedant.
Yeah, I just read Vedant's thing.
Hmm. You did not review why?
Hmm?
You did not review why?
You didn't ask, he asked him.
I think. Oh. Check message.
Proposal I just sent.
Yeah. I sent you everything on chat message.
No, that's better. Okay. In fact, we can slowly, we might have time to be set.
No, I have a meeting with Dr. Rural.
Tomorrow?
Yeah, tomorrow I can do.
So now you both tell me your condition.
So this is the answer for the exercise. This is how you have to do it. You have to put multiple LSAT rules to make your own grade calculator.
Thank you.
Having trouble? I figured out something about people.
You finish that with that?
That? Okay. So we will go to the loops. So there are two types of loop, for loops and while loops. First, we will see while loops. So a while loop is used when you want to repeat a block of code multiple times and until the condition is true. So it will print until the condition is true, okay? So try to print this thing like my list. It will go in, so I is equals to zero, and it will do the length of, calculate, length function will calculate the length of list here. And then I plus equals to one is I equals to I plus one, that will just increment the loop, the condition of I. So you remember from upper that my list have 1, 2, 3, and 4 in it. From here, if you see, this is my list and it have 1, 2, 3, 4. It will run until all these elements are there in the list. So while loop will run until all the elements are there in the list. And then if we want to do the for loop is when you know that you have the proper number of iterations. Let's say it have 4 iterations, so it will calculate the range of that list that you need to run it 4 times and print whatever is in the list. So you have to print my list and then I in it. It will print the exact number, like the index. So I will carry the index of that list. If you want to, if in the I 0, it will print 1, then 2, then 3, then 4. So these two types of loops are there in the Python.
And then give you some exercise then. You can write a program that prints the Fibonacci sequence up to the given number of number. That is in the other GitHub collab, the link you got. And it says session 1A. If you open that, you will find it over there. And still some guys are doing that, so I will wait for them.
You can do Fibonacci series here in this. And if you have already done the Fibonacci series, you can try doing to solve this exercise, which is next to it. You have to, in this exercise, you have to ask a user to enter a number and then display the multiplication table from that number. So you need to write a code for that and you need to write loops for that. Try to do that. The output will be like this. Enter a number. If a user enter a number 7, that it will print the multiplication table for 7. And you can use a logic like this, like you used in the Fibonacci series.
Thank you.
You need to define a loop that will take range from 1 to 10, and then whatever number you enter, it just prints some multiplication table till 10. So you need to define just one variable for the indexing, and then use it only.
So you can see here the output. It will print like this. So it is taking 1 to, it wants a number to be entered between 1 to 10. So we need to define 1 to 11 to see the range of 0 to 10 or 1 to 10. And then I will take like 1. So that's the range. Then how it will work like is that first I will take equals to 1. Then in the result, it will be like, let's say it the user entered 7, then it will print 7 into 1. Then it will go again to the next loop. In result, it will again print 7 into 2 because we have incremented the number, and then it will just run into the loop. And that's how it is printing 7 into 1 to 7 into 10. And we have a print function here. So it is printing the number inside this thing. Range is a function, so it will check like what two numbers are there, and then it will just print, do the loop in that two numbers. So now if we want to define these kinds of things, if we want to use again and we want to improve the readability of the code, then we need to use functions. So functions are responsible if we want to reuse these codes. Let's say we want to print the square and we want to do it multiple times. So we will define a function for that, and we can use that functions anywhere we want in our code. So def is used for defining a function in Python. And then you need to define the name of the function. Square is the function name. And then you put the arguments in it. Arguments means that what you need to put inside the function and calculate that thing. So that will be a kind of variables or other arguments which we can pass inside the function. So here it is simply calculating the square of the x variable inside it. And these double stars here, it will be the like square. If you put any other number also, it will just make sure that it is the power of that number. And then it will return x power 2. And in multiply, it will return a into b. So you can try these things. And this functions, this is the example that you are calling a function inside a function. So you can use this function anywhere you want in the code. So multiply first, it will multiply 3 into 2. That will be a and b in the function. And the multiplication will return the 6. And the square function will return the 6 power 2. So that is the answer is 36.
So def square is the definition, then return x will be the body of the function, and then this is the calling of the function. Like in the parentheses, we are calling the function.
So let's move to the exercise of using functions. So this is another example, like how to calculate the sum, but the exercise is this, like you have to print a triangle pattern like this. And I have give you a sample, like a code here, how to start with, how to enter a number. Just try your logic here, how to print a pattern, triangle pattern here.
Yeah. I think single bar, a single standard set. Something in the environment.
Can you just
think
into the loop?
They say combine all this in the screen.
No, you want answers? Let's see the answer.
Yeah, we should do something.
It's not even teaching it. Okay. So you have to define a range until the number is there, and then you need to call it into two loops. First loop is to take the number, and then you have to print the row and columns both, right? So for first loop is for the rows and the second is for the columns, and then you have to print it. And here you are calling the function and putting the number which you are taking it from the input from the user. Everyone get it?
You already done? Yeah. Okay. We did start something else in the notebook.
Yeah, we can figure this out. Oh, that is.
Is it a simple? Yeah.
So we find it inside it. So we can take care of the equals to, and we need to take care of an abundant content. So this one is for the poly and silent.
You can try something fun, printing a smiley. Just copy paste it from the thing, and then you have to turn this a sad smiley to a happy smiley.
After this, we will make a password manager. So how many of you struggle to remember the password? All of you. So let's try to make a password manager in which you can store your passwords. So logic is locked. The logic will be here. Whatever you pass it here, it will assign the address. But you leave the variable and see how it will be the same. But the variable inside it, it will be the same as the same.
So chain happens to be free. But the same thing in the problem is using first.
Yeah, so this is the variable you put the input and you pass that input here. And this you pass it here. So it needs not to be same as this, but you can see it put num equals to number. Also. So that will make you understand just one. And then when you pass this number into it, then it will assign it to num variable. That num variable will go inside and then give it. Let's see the address. I hope everyone is done. Or you can do this as an exercise at home. And you can do this as a homework that you need to write a program to guess the number, and it will come out of the loop when you have guessed the correct number. And you can do this as an exercise. So if you want to store your passwords, you need a variable name, a password, and def main is a main function which is there by default in the Python, which you can use always. And you need to store your password into a list. So we are assigning a list. We are using all the concepts which we learned so far till now. So we will be using all of them to write our password manager. Then you need to ask the user that you are welcome to the password manager. Then you have to ask them that
if you want to add a new password or if you want to save the password or to view the password, right? So if you want to add a new password, it will call another function that will be addPassword. And in the view password, it will call the function view password. And in the addPassword, we are using the append, which will be appending to the list of the password which we used here. Okay. And it will print back that your password is saved successfully. Then if you want to view password, you need to again do like press enter the two. On the entering the two, it will call the choice view password. And then it will show you the password which you have already saved. So you can go into this password manager demo and try it out. It is on the GitHub link. That will use all the concepts, that will use function, that will use loops, that will use list, and then calling function inside a function.
The nested loop is like you will do the loop inside the loop, and the program you get to create the triangle pattern. That was an example of nested loop. That you have to create first rule and then that is nested loop.
What's the next number? That's it.
to 14 lines of code.
It's just printing all other stuff.
Once in a while.
Let me know if I have to scroll down.
Try to see the mirror. The text is
So this will be the last exercise after this we are having lunch. So let's complete this and let me know when you all are done.
Can you pause and ask like which
Sorry.
That's the first thought. Oh, we can how we can ever resources.
Will you guys make it to the room?
Yeah, I mean, she coded it all.
We didn't have to make it.
Sorry? We just have to use it.
Ah, okay.
I think we got logged off from Dr. Shit's account. So I don't know what is happening. I'm not able to. Well, I think it's all.
So I hope you guys had a better understanding of Python today. And please go and try to replicate yourselves, change yourselves and whatever. Yeah. if you want to get into machine learning or AI or anything, this is like the first step, Python. If you do have to learn.
Yeah, I don't know the password.
Of what? Zoom is closed. It's closed anyway.
Yes.
No. Yeah. So that's it for one session. You guys can have that.
Thank you. Sometimes I know when I check that phone that I was in training last week, so it didn't. Yeah, it's. Yeah. I'm going to go to the next one.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
भैया खाने ले क्यों दिल में?
It's not, it's not all. It's When are you going for your visa update?
In July.
Oh, okay. Hold on, I'll ask. I don't. Okay, I'm just gonna remove that.